Hi, welcome to MooMooMath. Today we're going to look at angles in a parallelogram. Well, first of all, we need to know what is a parallelogram. And a parallelogram is a quadrilateral, meaning a polygon with four sides, where the opposite sides are parallel. So we have the top parallel to the bottom. So BC is parallel to AD, and AB is parallel to DC. Now, that's the main property in what defines a parallelogram. One property of a parallelogram is that the opposite angles are congruent to each other. So angle B up here will be the same measure as angle D. So let's give it a measure. Let's say that angle B is 120 degrees. That means that angle D would also be 120 degrees. Now, A and C are congruent, but they have to have a relationship to D and B. And the relationship is that these two, what we call consecutive angles, are supplementary, meaning they add up to 180 degrees. So if this angle is 120, then this angle has to be 60, and this angle is 60. So any pair of consecutive angles are supplementary. These two are supplementary, these two are supplementary, these two are supplementary, and then these two are supplementary. And then, of course, the opposite angles are congruent. So let's try a practice problem. Let's change these numbers. And let's say that angle C up here is 80 degrees. We can figure out the other three angles. What do we know about angle A? Angle A would also have to be 80 degrees. And then angle D and B would have to be supplementary to 80, which means they each have to be 100 degrees because opposite angles are congruent and adjacent angles are supplementary. Hope this video was helpful on angles in a parallelogram.